Good evening, good people. Happy Sunday, happy Holy Sunday. It's Revelation Time Show once again. You all know Sunday's evening, they all belong to Revelation Time Show with your boy, your brother, and it's where we preach and teach the word of God. It's all about Jesus Christ and Him alone. Angithembe bafethu ukuthi sonke sile emabandleni sahamba sayokhonza namhlanje kusuku olukhulu, usuku lokuhlangana kwabazalwane. Uthi iBhayibheli ningakiyeki ukuhlangana. So it's very important ukuthi sihlangane as abazalwane sidumise sikhulisane kwezikamoya. Kulabo ke mhlawumbe bebesebenza sithi iRevelation Time Show is always your backup because ila khona esifundisa khona izwi kaNkulunkulu, sikhuluma izwi kaNkulunkulu sosondela. If you have the chance ukuthi ukwazi ukuya esontweni ngenxa yokuthi ubusebenza ubusy noma khona obukwenza, ngithi sondela ke sesishayile isikhathi. Njengoba ubona it's written in the screen ukuthi namhlanje sisaqhubeka nayo i-topic yethu ukuthi can a believer lose his salvation. Last week we had my brother Minister Siya Shabane umfowethu befundisa ke enama scriptures or wa share ama scriptures, we discussed sagcina sethi a believer can never lose his salvation, because if sithi a believer can lose his salvation, shoot into enziwe uJesu into engekho. So usho njalo-ke umfowethu last week. So you'll know that really a lot of vibes. Please do share the live and mention people. Meme nje abantu umeme nje ungasabi akube mnandi. Nalamhlanje-ke bafethu ngiyanithembisa ukuthi kuzoba mnandi. Just grab your pen, your diary or your notebook, and then iBhayibheli libalekile libe seduze kwakho. Because la I'm with my brother, my very own brother, Pastor Sibusiso Ngcobo, but uzozithula yena azisho. My brother, can you please introduce yourself to our people, to our viewers? Uzisho ukuthi ubani? Namhlanje sizokhuluma ngani?
Thatha YouTube mfethu ngikubingelela brother Ngcobo, ama listeners wakho, abalandeli bakho bonke kule podcast onayo. Igama ngusibuwa kaNgcobo, umfundisi uNgcobo ebandleni Debenership Center under umfundisi uMasinga. Ngokuhlala ngikhona la eThekwini, nangokusebenza futhi ngikhona la eThekwini. Kuyintokozo ukuthi ngibe la kulosuku lanamhlanje mfowethu.
No, asibonge fuze mfowethu. So njengoba ngishilo mfowethu ukuthi this is my brother. We serve under Bishop Masinga, that is our father. So siyanamukela nalabo abangenawo manje, siyanamukela. You know that really need a vibe. Share a life buffet and mention people, kuzoba mnandi kakhulu. Without waste of any time, namhlanje sifike elike, niyabona ukuthi it's 6:06. So ukuthi uyangena manje ungacabanga ukuthi ufike late, you are right on time. Into ongayenza nje wena ukuthi extend the invitation, mention people and share a life. My brother, ask your sister ukuthi wena namhlanje mfowethu usiphatheleni. Last week with one of my brother uSiya Shabane, the minister, the teacher of the word, sahlala sa discussa naye. He was teaching and quoting scriptures ethi a believer can never lose his salvation. What Christ did was permanent. So ngalokho a believer can never lose in salvation. So as guest is my brother esadini lakho ukuthi namhlanje wena usiphatheleni, ikuphi esizobuzwa, is it mhlawumbe the same thing or is it different? And then yeah, we are ready with our Bibles and we are ready to learn. So the platform is all yours, my brother.
Hi, ngiyabonga kakhulu mfowethu. Mhlawumbe angiqale ngale disclaimer le ethi as Christians or as abazalwane njengabantwana bakaNkulunkulu, yonke into esiyenzayo siyenza ngothando, and uma sonke sabazalwane sikhonza uNkulunkulu ngoKristu Jesu, konke suke sikwenza giving all honor and glory unto him. Sisuke sizama ukuletha wonke umuntu azo understand ngezinto uJesu ayikhuluma kubafundi bakhe, abafundi bakhe bayiphasela kithi through the Bible and the Holy Spirit. Why ngisho lokho? It's because we shall never divide because of scriptures or because of doctrine. Singaba nayo imibono engafani, kodwa lokho akusho ukuthi we should divide. Ngingaboni ke seliyi-one. At some point, we need to find common grounds through engaging and allowing the Holy Spirit to give us a proper interpretation, because the Bible will never contradict itself. We may have different views, kodwa uloma different views allow at some point, if we sit down as Christians, allowing the Holy Spirit to give us the illumination of his word, so was ukuthi sibe stress sithola one common ground about a specific doctrine. So we shall never divide. We shall never divide over scriptures. It's fortunate for me now that I'm going to go the same route in agreeing with the previous speaker, Bonaso. I didn't have time to ulalela sona. I didn't know what was his position, but it gave me great joy that we believe in the same doctrine, we believe in the same interpretation of the scriptures when it comes to that. So I'm that person who believes that a Christian will never lose his salvation. I'm one of those people. Kuhle ukuthi uma sikhuluma izinto enje, which I believe they are critical, sikwazi ukuthi sibe nama scriptures which gonna back whatever that you are saying. And with the hope ukuthi sizoveza ukuthi our interpretation is correct and come from the Holy Spirit. If there is someone else who have a different view, ngoba ngisho nje, we are not enemies. We are still Christian, we are still brothers. Let us engage with love and try to find common ground. So quote kakhulu John when it comes to discussing the topic here namhlanje. Sizoqala nje ngo John chapter 6 verse 39. John chapter 6 verse 39, little Bible. This is the will of the Father who sent me, that all who has given me should lose nothing, but raise it up on the last day. Kunezinto ayishoyo uJesu la, uJesu okhuluma la mazwi lawa, okhuluma nabafundi nabafarisi ababekhona ngaleso sikhathi ekhuluma la mazwi, uthi kuyintando kaBaba. That statement alone, singakafiki ukuthi yini le azokhuluma ngayo. Uma nje, once what it's the will, uNkulunkulu will never go against his will. Iwill yakhe iyona emveza ukuthi abe uNkulunkulu ngaphezu kwakho konke okhona emhlabeni. That is why the book of Ephesians athi he does everything according to the counsel of his will. Isichaza ukuthi uNkulunkulu uyasithatha isikhathi ahlale ezulwini abe semithingeni according to his will. Uma ukuthi sithi umuntu, uma se ukuthi phela kayena umuntu, I'm just making an example la. Ukuthi uma sesebona ukuba ngaso sikhona confused yayo, ubuyela back to his will. So that ezokwazi ukubona ukuthi is he still continuing with his plan. So by saying that, whatever statement esilandelayo, sichaza ukuthi kumele senze ngaleyo ndlela. Ithini ke intando kaNkulunkulu? Ithi that all he has given me, I shall lose nothing. But I should raise it up on the last day. Basically, this is the will of him who sent me, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him shall have everlasting life. So that's because again, because we see unkwawe intando kaNkulunkulu ukuthi abantu abasindiswe ingakhetha umelini uJesu. Abantu bazosindiswa kanjani? Bazosindiswa ukuthi bayibone indodana, bakholelwe indodana. Bese ukuthi bonke laba bakholelwe indodana banjani, balethwe uNkulunkulu, noma they've been caused by God to be born again. And the labo bantu labo, they shall have everlasting life. But number one, according out before Asholobo, would say, I shall lose nothing. Akeko no one, umuntu ozokholelwa uNkosi uJesu Kristu bese elahlekelwe nokuphila kwakhe. Because when you speak about salvation, it's about us spending our eternity with God in heaven because we've believed in the Son. So that's the first statement engifuna ukuvula ngaso. Esizama ukusecura noma ukusekonda ipoint elithi we shall never lose our salvation. Anganoma ngisangisamba kahle asho continue or
yeah, ngaqhubeka my friend.
Okay, thank you, sir. In saying that, as in the book of John chapter 10, verse 28. As I've said, I will quote and the quote John when it comes to this topic. John chapter 10, verse 28. I give them eternal life, and I shall never perish. Neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. This is the assurance that Jesus is giving us. This is the assurance of the work that Jesus has came to do. It's an assignment which uma ethi esthambanweni I finished all these things that I've said before. Ukuthi kubaba umuntu mthi ngizozenza. So, which means mthi akekho umuntu ongabahlwithe esandleni sakhe. Chaza ukuthi la basebengenile esandleni sika Jesu. Noma laba sebengenile esandleni se protection yale salvation. No one can snatch them out of leso sandla leso. It's an assurance, it's a statement, it's something that Jesus was decreeing here. Ukuthi we are safe, our salvation is safe with him. That is why ngikhotha sho abapostoli ngcono ngisho ngikhotha lawa sho yena lokhu yena wayezokwenza umsebenzi. And then the last one before we engage further, John chapter 17, verse 12. John chapter 17, verse 12. Uthi, while uJesu uyathandaza la, uthandaza kubaba, uthandazela abafundi bakhe bangaleso sikhathi, nabafundi abazayo. Uthi, while I was with them in the world, I kept them in your name. Those whom you gave me, I have kept them. And none of them is lost except the son of predestination. Thandaza uJesu. Umuntu uzothi but lana uyathandazela abafundi. Usho kanjani ukuthi we are included. Muwehla kancane. Uwehla lapha uya ku verse 20. Uthi, I do not pray for this alone, but also for those who will believe in me through their word, which means their prayer of verse 12 was for abefundi baka Jesu ngalesikhathi esanabo, but including anyone else who will believe amagama amazwi azobefundiswa abapostoli because they have received from Jesus. So this is the assurance for everyone who have came to believe in Jesus for the word of Jesus and their faith. So those grievances, because it's kind of so I don't want to get a little bit of but those are one of my main scriptures when it comes. So what assurance do I have? Ukuthi lento esengiyitholile iyona and futhi ngeke ngisaphuma kuyona. But ngikukhona into ayishilo uJesu lapha ya ku verse 12 ukuthi ukhona umuntu oyedwa owake walahlekelwa yi-salvation yakhe, which was uJudas Iscariot. And that part, ungcono uJesu wasiza wayi-clarifya, because ukuba akayi-clarifyanga ngabe sinenkinga yokuchaza izinto ey'ningi. Uyazivezela uJudas Iscariot it was a prophecy, it was prediction, it had to happen. So asikwazi ukuyithatha sizoyifaka in our real life, because that was predicted. That is why it's no one was lost except the son of predestination, which was Judas Iscariot. So, but ngiyakho ngikuveza lokuyana, because ukuba akakuvezanga uJesu wakushiya kuhanging, ngabe sesinama discussion amaningi kumele siwachaze manje in the issue of Judas Iscariot. But my brother, ngoba ngisho ngifuna at least sesibonile le claims ne understanding ukuthi why ngikhamuka phi ngalento ye salvation yethu kuhle ukuveza lokho ukuthi there are three kinds of people aba involved when discussing this matter yabo njengoba sengihlelele the statement ukuthi asoze sayiluse salvation kunezinto ezothree ezenzakalayo ezinamacategory awu three abantu ecategory abantu bokuqala ekade bengazi ukuthi uyes noma uno ukuthi we can lose or we cannot lose so us speaking like this through ama scriptures wethu we give them that confidence to understand ukuthi we won't and now must be able back to the scripture by the help of the Holy Spirit they will come to be in the same understanding with us bese kuba khona the category abantu besibili because of the interpretation of their own interpretation of the scripture bathi bona we can lose salvation right and they have scriptures which they quote in regard to their standing point of view njengoba ngikhuluma kanje what's happening in their minds most of the time i reasoning ethi we are running a risk yokuthi sibe nama Christian which are careless because of this eternal security that we're talking about and then bagcina sebenza izinto haphazard that the second category of people which them into engenza ngingabi ngingakuphatheki ngabi kakhulu labo it's because chaza ukuthi they are serious with their work they know the consequences of sin and living the haphazard life so they try by all means to live their life within or in the context of the scriptures so that they can remain in the will or in doing the will of God but this is why I'm not worried about them kakhulu because they are within the premise of a good Christian work engwabithi kakhulu ngabi laba besithathu yilaba abakade vele beyazi lento noma beyizwile basukuyizwa kabo it's not guided by the scriptures they've lived their life in they living their life in sin they living they're walking in this walk of Christianity haphazardly they living their life using the term freedom to abuse the grace and to abuse those are the one that I'm really concerned about when it comes to this hence in the next discussion going forward is to give a warning to those people because just ukusho nje lethe sishoyo ukuthi we cannot lose our salvation quoting these scriptures it's a good thing and futhi ku right and we are using the principle of God but ukuyisho kanjalo sishiye kanjalo we are running a danger of having Christians who are abusing or using it grace to continue in their sin hence I'm going to the next step of this discussion I'm not sure if should I continue or want to say something my brother
let me just quickly go to ama comments and see ukuthi bathini mhlambe sike siphendule bona nabo bazizwe bamkelekile and then maybe again we can carry on ngoba isikhathi sisavuma ake ngithathe nje ngizothatha nje ama questions mhlambe noma ama opinions ambalwa okay ake ngiqale ngale uMajola K is saying John chapter 10 verse 27 to 29 King James my sheep hear my voice and I know them and they follow me and I give them eternal life and they shall never perish never shall anyone snatch them out of my hand my father who has given them to me is greater than all and no one is able to snatch them out of my father's hand indeed no one can snatch people from God's hands even Paul attests to that sufferings can move us away this does not negate the fact that we can live that comes from uMajola K and then uBarnabas uthi yes accept the son of prediction because he never believed but those who heard the message of his death burial and resurrection shall be completely secured in eternal salvation. I think this one comes from Scaliot. And then umsizi Ngcobo Ngcobo uthi power kuleyo ndawo sindawonge lapho khuphuka kakhulu. And then again aqhamuke uMajola uthi John 17 chapter 12, while I was with them in the world, I kept them in your name. Those whom you gave me, I've kept. And none of them is lost except the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. How was Judas lost if he was not in Christ in the first place? So my brother, ngingacela mhlawumbe kulama comment njengashilo uthi phegu phegu kuwona and sibone ukuthi singakwazi nosiphinde sithatha abanye.
I think if I heard correct, about the first two or three, they were agreeing with what I was saying, putting an emphasis in emphasis on the same scriptures, if I heard correct, but you'll correct me if I've missed something. The only person on us when the question you know trainer about Judas Iscariot. I think I began.
Yes, okay. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. As I continue, answer umfowethu lo obuze about Judas Iscariot. He will be answered. I promise him. We will be answered. I have a reason, in understanding why even Judas was lost, because there is no one who's born again who's supposed to be lost. I still maintain that. Let's take a step further on this discussion. Let us go to Hebrews. I will read two things. We zona most of the time. People who are saying we might or we can lose our salvation, they use these scriptures. And based on those scriptures, I will do two things. I will explain why I believe those scriptures do not say we can lose our salvation. At the same time, I will use those scriptures, the danger of those people who are using, let us to live a sinful life, to live a life which is not pleasing to God, because there is a danger to that. So as I'm engaging on this, I'm killing two birds with one stone, trying to clarify why I believe with these scriptures, they do not say we can lose our salvation, but at the same time, it's a warning for us. So I see in Hebrews, chapter 10, Hebrews chapter 10, I think verse 14. Chapter 10, verse 26. For if we sin willfully after we have received the knowledge of truth, there is no longer remaining a sacrifice for sin, but a certain fearful expectation of judgment and fear, ignition which will devour the adversary. If we continue to sin willingly after we have received the knowledge of truth, there is no longer remaining a sacrifice for sin. Then Sizobano chapter 6 verse 4, Hebrews. Those are the two scriptures and go on a manje in going forward. Chapter 6, verse 4. For it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted their heavenly gift and have become the partakers of the Holy Spirit and have tasted the good word of God and the power of the age to come, if they fall away, to renew them again to repentance, since they has crucified again for themselves the Son of God and put him unto shame. So those are the two scriptures. I know they want to put us in a very difficult spot sometimes when we engage in this matter. But so that's so pumala see why I believe what these scriptures they not contradicting what we always or what we are talking about. For this one, the sister ginayo into 80, especially Uma Sizo Lapago John. I think John chapter 2. John chapter 2, verse 19. So let's not say off on the Lamar verse. I'm going to find the one can work that. First John chapter 2, verse 19. They went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they've been of us, they would have continued with us. But they went away that they might be made manifest that none of them were us. I think he'll pin the foot. They went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they've been of us, they would have continued with us. But they went out that they might be made manifest that none of them they were us. So whatever the issue from now going forward, now in Nikita Egnigeza a standing point. Labo we born Abashiro Ukolo. I got to see now. Bapuma Bahamba. If I paid it out, we shared them post on power. They were very was a lady, they were not of us. One kumuntu also figure Abbe Nazi or Colin, Bessia humble shield, Colowak. Upostol Power, Umpostol Uchon, Lana, we are shared with him. Was a lady, they were not of us. Begumed the humble, so that they will be made manifest. So because Guti who come back wabo sex offers at Yedi Uguti Vele was a Kaleni, they were not of us. Hence, my brother no crewing in the bag to the skiros with the Judas Kairos, we beg asking. Uguti Vele Uchutas was a Kaleni, he was never saved, although he was with Jesus. Because if he was saved, he was not gonna sell out to Jesus. He was not gonna betray Jesus. He was not gonna do everything. Hello. Why is this on Jaru? I kumbula in the ba gamere umma eyo tata mafuta noma the oil, the expensive oil. I wash and I in was got Jesus. Contest you a puppy like man swing at. Difficulty, Judas Iscariot will complain about how, why is he Moshe? Into expensive gangala. My best sister, my foot, I saw a daisa. Which is your pendulum would know about to pay in your shadow now. Best pipe against that specialty. Which is so cool, my long over very bemazo to the scarrow to go to base cave and go fail. Be good to you, my farmer offering which is Judas at your mind. So that part shows us the character of who Judas Carrot was, although he was with Jesus. So that is why in this scripture, let's join. Sister Niggas, the assurance, no matter how much he preached, no matter how much he was a prophet, a miracle worker, whatever that you can think of, a great giant in the giant of faith, in the work of faith, if he went out, that person, as from where to go, he was not of us. And it's a manifestation the day he left. So, you are calling it a spade glamour vessel and I was cooling our own. Just the moment to tell me food that Job and Nami struggled a lot, especially Gaubon chapter 10. For the chapter 10, you turn to go by lighting yan yan. A wee loaner has to teach together in the clicking and line or chapter 6 got Hebrews. Because chapter 6 of Kuluman on Moon to 1, listen, that's how he was enlightened that person. Number 2, he was a partaker of the Holy Spirit. Number 3, he enjoyed the good work of the Word. So as I wanted those into Wuti Muila and Sisara, I say, it isn't as Wuti is on a lazy weasel, is then the silver of Bantana Bagankulun. But we are Shella Umpaloma Hebrews, Uguti, that person, it is possible for him, Uguti, he must live, he will live. No more he can be excluded from salvation, or he must be excluded from the promises of God. But konigama elibalulekile ekuyilona lesinikezayo ukuthi why esho le nto le. Abomu chapter 6 mesufunda ku chapter 6 konigama eli 1 elibalulekile laphaya kulento ayishoyo umbhalo amaHebheru. Uthi, verse 6, if they fall away, to renew again to repentance. Leanto leana iti, we prada ngeu. That person tasted the good things of the heaven, walked the walk of faith in his way. He enjoyed or partake in the Holy Spirit. Why go to chapter 6, 18? Any version, he didn't have enough time or time that led him to repentance. Because this person, he might have fallen away. What he meant, when he was fallen away, he didn't have time. No, he didn't get an opportunity to what? That to lead him to repentance. Which means this is a person who was in a state where he fall away. When he fall away, he enjoyed the sin. He lived life in sin instead of the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit leads us into repentance. That's where we differentiate. Uguti, are you just a partaker of the Holy Spirit, or are you being led by the Holy Spirit? Because the Holy Spirit will lead you into repentance. This person, when he fall away, he didn't get a chance. He didn't push. He didn't do all means to go back into repentance. So that is the uyenumuntu umntwana kaNkulunkulu ke lo simbona ngani simbona ukuthi he is quick to go to repentance. If he is quick to go to repentance, then the assurance that he is always in God, living in God, iba lapho ngaleso sikhathi. That is why it's a danger kumuntu who's taking this bese efuna ukuphila willingfully. Chapter 10, that's a common, is the person who's willingfully sinning. Into inkinga ngedanger of willingfully sinning. Into ethi, you enjoy sin, you sin not out of compelled, but being compelled to sin, but you sin because you enjoy sin. The more you enjoy sin, flesh rules you. When flesh rules you, you are quasi to harm or you repent because you enjoy what you are doing. For instance, I need to now we are children of the light. Not that we are perfect, but we are being sanctified daily so that we can be led to perfection. You'll be perfect when Jesus comes back to take us to be with the Father. So the process of sanctification and us living in the world eating. Ngale skathi ubaba Ngcobo ethola eku situation where he has sinned or done evil. Because I'm the child of the light, I will go and expose my sin. Ethi iBhayibheli, darkness shall never prevail against this light. Because ukuthi, when I'm in darkness, I go to the light, I expose the darkness. When I expose the darkness, the light will defeat darkness in me and then help me to continue to stay in the light. But a person who is a sinner willingly, what he do, he or she becomes a person of darkness. Instead of exposing his darkness or her darkness to the light, he hides the darkness. He lives in darkness, which means that person is willingly sinning. And for that person, he is bringing Christ's work into a shame. One thing is sure. So in ngakho kuba nzima ukuthi lowo muntu loyo a repent. And mase ngasa repent, akekho umuntu oyinkinga njengomuntu ongarepent. Into esenza sibe bazalwane ukuthi every day, abone musa vuga umuntu mesa ewile esonweni ekwazi uvuka ayokhala kuNkulunkulu akakhali ngobethanda umoya ingcwele ngaphakathi kuyena uyena omenza ukuthi ahambe ayo repenta. So the Holy Spirit is at work to that person because the Spirit of God lead us into repentance. But must we start repenting, then that's where the problem, because which means whatever that you are doing, it, you are enjoying it. Christ has become lesser and lesser in your life, and then flesh and this lust of this world is becoming higher and higher and higher. And then what's happening? You die in sin. And when that happened, because what vele was a kaleni, you were not one of us. You were walking with us. You knew the words, you knew the languages, you knew the song that you were singing, but you were not one of us. Then, let me make an example. Owesifazane uma se ebanjiwe ephinga bamletha bafarisi. Lithi iBhayibheli, I'm just paraphrasing what I'm saying, nalela verse. Right. Uthi uJesu, uma nina nonke ngoba nisekukhanyeni ongenabo i-darkness akamjaje kuqala. Now, this is what happened. Because the Pharisees enjoyed being in the darkness. They didn't want to expose themselves in the light. They moved away. They ran away. Kwasala wesifazane, who is willing to say, vele ngisebumnyameni, ngibanjwe ebumnyameni, but I'm coming to the light. And then what happened? The light overcome darkness and it gave her life and she became a child of a light. So that's very important. How, that is why we sinning willfully can be a result that you have never been saved. God, you are coming to church, you read the word, you worship, but you are doing this thing, you might find yourself and that's the problem. So the last point, but what about those little people? They were partakers of the Holy Spirit. They enjoyed the powers of the age to come. Maybe you've never asked yourself, who Jesus uma ethi, baningi abazoza kumina, bathi inkosi inkosi, sikhiphile nje amadimoni ngegama lakho, saphilisa abantu ngegama lakho. Mina ke ngokufunda iBhayibheli, no one who can prophet ongaba umprophet outside of the Holy Spirit. Umprophet is because umprophet is because he received from the Holy Spirit. UJesu lapha nakasho ukuthi labantu baba prophet bamanga. No, they are not prophet bamanga. They are prophesying in his name, they are prophesying correct things. But it's iBhayibheli, he never knew them. Which means it is impossible to be a partaker of the Holy Spirit, but you are not saved, you are not born again, you are not known in heaven. Yilabake chapter 6 okhuluma ngayo laphayani. It is possible ukuthi uprofete ukwenze konke, only find out that wena masufa uzofela esonweni ungarepentanga, meaning as the journey continue, you leave us, you will manifest yourself. Ukuthi, you are not better, you are not part of us. So that is why it's a warning for me, kulabo who are using this topic as a means of them to live in sin willingly. It's a danger. You are running a risk. You are in the wrong side with God.
Yo, Mapolo, Prophet, thank you very much for this. Prophet, ngiyathemba ukuthi you guys are enjoying. Yabona, Mapolo baziyakhala lapha kwa comments. Angazi ngampela ukuthi imaphi engizowathatha ngwashiye because la kwa comments zikhala ngampela. Uyayazi imvula, but kunawo two engifisa ukuthi mhlawumbe iwona engizothi read them out. Mhlawumbe siphendule wona because la amanye most yawo ngiyabona ukuthi abantu la bayaphikisana, bayaphendulana, bayabuzana, bayaphendulana. So ngenxa yokuthi bayaphendulana, ake ngithathe le engaphenduliwe imibuzo and then mhlawumbe ungasiphendulela yona. And then kunonqobile Zindela uthi there are people who now deny Jesus, those that were with us but are now practicing the things of the world. Someone is asking about how far grace goes. Denying him in public, now you in front of his father. I think Matthew chapter 10, verse 33. And then Master Kubegatini, at now, does this mean that God writes our names nge pencil so that it can be erasable? There are scriptures that state that if we do certain things, we will not inherit the kingdom of God. My brother, ngicela ukuthi simphendule unqola, and then because kunenye futhi question ekhona la eqhamuke kumajola akhe engifuna ukuthi sisi attend because yona uze walokhu uze wakhotha script. So can you please ukuthi mhlawumbe sizame ukuphendula unqoko kulokho akushona?
Okay. Ngoba ngisho nje ukuthi shawo ukuthi this is one of the broader topics and our one to justice. But we try by all means to cover everyone and to engage further if times allows us. I was basically facing this in your fair, but I'm not winning. I think you could join God. Elithi labo who akekho umuntu who can confess Jesus ngaphandle kwamoya engcwele. Once umuntu wa confess ukuthi he believes in Jesus, the Holy Spirit has caused him to do that. Either way, those who publicly deny, abona laba kade ngiba ade ngibachaza la, they've never went out on public to say, hey, uJesu, uJesu yaphetha, uJesu this. But khona ke laba bakwenzayo, labo bangcono labo, because they've clearly went in public and say, no, we sibiza nge apostates. They've left faith. They no longer believe in Jesus. They no longer, because but I guess who called what woman or mom to Jesus, you go say, who called on it is good to offer up in the world. So when you go on public street and speak about Jesus, Engafanga, Noma, Yamanga, whatever that you can say as a blasphemy to his work, you are doing that which is coming from devil, because that's what Satan is doing. So those one, they not of us. They were never even of us, because they are clearly publicly saying it to go to Jesus as your own course.
Wow. Thank you very much. No building at time go to pendule again. And then gonna mean you two and go by very come go to head as the funu go see locals. Pendule ible. Okay, but angisayiboni ngenxa yokuthi ama-comment maningi, but ngiyayikhumbula ibithi can you please explain the scripture uJohn chapter 15 verse 1 to 6?
John chapter 15 verse 1 to 6,
the vine and the branches, verse 1 to 6. And then Master Watin futhi Master umbuzo wesibili uthini, whose names get removed from the book of life, the saved or unsaved? So it's only those two. Whose name gets removed from the book of life, the saved or the unsaved?
Removed, okay. Chapter 16, verse 1, right?
Right.
15 verse 1 to 6.
Okay, I am the true vine, my father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away, and every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes that it may bear more fruit. You are already clean because of the word which I've spoken to you. Abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear its fruits of itself unless it abide in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I'm the vine. Okay, let's just stop there, because we all know the scripture. Verse 1 and 2 ulinked noma ingcikithi yakhona ulapha ku 3 and 4. Asiqale ngo 4. Abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit out of itself. Uthen uthu, every branch that does not bear fruit is being cut. Go to 3. We actually go to obane who does not bear fruit. yilabo who are not in Christ. So obanika abakhathwayo yilabo abangekho kuJesu. That is why they do not bear fruit. Akekho umuntu okuJesu who cannot bear fruit. Understand what I'm trying to say? That is why he gave us that. Ukuthi, nina, you are already in me. Abide in me so that you can continue to bear fruit. But these ones who are being cut are the ones who are not bearing fruit. But the question is, why are they not bearing fruit? It's because they are not in him. Which means they've never believed in Jesus. Because those who believe in Jesus will bear fruit. Uzobona uma sesivala ukuthi why in assurance ukuthi every person who is in Jesus will bear fruit. Maybe let me help by saying this thing. Maybe it will help us so that singagcina sishona kakhulu kaqalo. Asiqale lapha ku Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. Just I'm not running away from the question, but I'm just adding on the question. Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. Philippians chapter 1 verse 6 uthi be confident of these very things, that he who began a good work in you will bring it into completion until the day of Jesus Christ. Nento yokukholwa ikhona I role yomuntu osuke khona, but a person who's doing the work is God. The person who has started the work in us, it's God. A person who will lead this completion to work, this work into completion is God. Hence, uNkulunkulu won't have mercy on the day of judgment because he knows a person don't have a power to do that which he requires to do. The will of God, there is no flesh who can do the will of God. So what God does, through Holy Spirit, those who believe in Jesus, they receive the Holy Spirit. Those who receive the Holy Spirit, he will give them power to manifest. He will give them power to bear fruit. He will give them power to do the will of God. He will give them power to live in righteousness, not according to their own works. Because I am born again because I've been called by God to be born again. So those who do not rely on, who do not produce all these things, it's because they are not in God and are not receiving the Holy Spirit. Hence, they will be cut off in the last days.
Umajola, ngathi khona la ngekho webhi khona. Uthi, how are they cut? They cut from where? If they are not in Christ, how are they cut from the vine?
Okay. Wonke umuntu osemhlabeni uwumuntu kaNkulunkulu. Right? Sonke njengoba siphila nje emhlabeni kanje, we are people of God. Ingakho uJesu uma efika emhlabeni uzofela wonke umuntu. Kahle kahle ngokwaNkulunkulu, brother Nceku, ngabe wonke umuntu ake sithi nje so asibanga khona isono. Ngaba akekho umuntu omhedile. Ngaba akekho umuntu omJuda, ngaba akekho umuntu omNazaretha, ngaba akekho umuntu onjani. All of us, we are in God, we've been created by God to serve God and to enjoy God. Every human, no one ongafakiwe kuleyo nto leyo. But into essence ukuthi sibe kanje namhlanje, it's because there was sin. And when sin came, too much confusion emhlabeni wonke, right? Kwavela zonke, all these religions that are there, all everyone was there. That is why manje sekukhulunywa ngalawo who mesikhuluma about us. Yingakho sihleli sidiscussayo because sikhuluma ngalabo abasebekholelwa uJesu ngeqiniso, right? But naye into ebalulekile, uJesu have done so many parables athi umuyodoba ufike ufake inet ubambe bonke ofish. Njengoba nathi senze, sishumayela wonke umuntu. Nesishumayela wonke umuntu. When you hear the word of God, akekho umuntu who can hear the word of God outside of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will make you to hear the word of God and you get born again. When you get born again, bese kuba khona imhlabathi ye 3. Umhlabathi wama lothu umungena isidi kuona. Ufike ube nameva. Instead of this person looking unto God, he's being choked by the affairs of life. Lo muntu loyo, he himself, instead of appreciating this precious gift that's from God, through ufa ka Jesu, anaka izinto zomhlaba. And then that seed is being flushed away. Omunye ku umhlabathi onjani umhlabathi wasolwandle. Isidi ngakwazi ukungena. All these people, they've been caught. So they will be judged according to what you have heard the word. You've been given a chance. But because you did not embrace this love, this unconditional love from Jesus, because you did not see Jesus as the source of your life, and then you drifted away. So those people, the part of these people who are, we are being cursed because you had an opportunity. You are going to church. You are hearing these things. That is why in the book of Hebrews, if today you hear the voice of God, repent, which means we have heard the truth, you've fallen away, but you choose not to repent. So those people, automatically they disqualify themselves from the grace, the difficulties, they disqualify themselves from the plan of God. That is why he's drifting away.
Yeah. I'm afraid to lawa ama comments. I'm really sorry ukuthi ngeke ngikwazi ukuthi ngithathe nonke maningi kakhulu ama comment la. I keep using the word falling away. Right. Okay. Let me ask a question ke la ngakumina. Lapha la ma brother ku Galatians chapter 5 verse 21. UPaul kunento eyishoyo lapha ukuthi those who abenza sexual immorality, idolatry, debauchery, hatred, witchcraft, wabala nje zonke lezi zinto lezi. And then ubesethi lapha ku verse 21 ekugcineni, those who does all these things shall never inherit the kingdom of God. So what do you say ngalelo verse?
Okay. Paul was on this particular passage of scripture. That is why it's topic yakhona muyibuka ethi walking in the spirit. I'm not sure what yakho ukuthi ithini. He was emphasizing how to differentiate, because kulula ukuthi sonke siyakholwa kodwa bese kungabonakala ukukholwa kwethu. Right? Because abakholwayo, they need to live in the spirit. They need to have the fruits of the spirit. They need to manifest that the Holy Spirit is at work in them. If you remember when I was speaking about the Jesus coming to fulfill the law, righteousness, ukuthi Jesu, he came to remove us from the law, but he gave us a second law. He gave us the law of the spirit. The law of the spirit lived in us. So a person who lives or who has the law of the spirit living in him, that person cannot do these things. Cannot do adultery. Cannot be witchcraft. Cannot practice witchcraft. So if these things happen and you do them willingly, then you shall not see the kingdom of God. Right? Because you are no longer walking in the spirit. But those who walk in the spirit, they will kill the work of flesh, which are these things that Paul is talking about. And it doesn't mean that he's perfect. He can find himself being envious of one thing at some point in time in his life. But that person will be brought back to God, he will repent, the grace of God will cover him, and then you continue living and trying to be pleasing God by doing his will. But those who do this thing, they are not apologetic, those people. And no one believe they not walk in spirit, because there's a difference to walk in spirit and to walk in the flesh.
Wow. Asibonge kakhulu mfowethu. Hey, ziyakhanga. Yabona nje lawo ama comments eyindlela inqoba ngakhona, imvula yodwa kodwa ke mhlambe kwaphethu sesingakwazi ukuthi siphinde sinibone lapha kwa ama comments. Mzulwini uqhamusa uqhamuka nama questions. Uthi hey Mzulwini, uthini Mzulwini? How will you know if how will you know if you are in Jesus and are filled with the Holy Spirit? Awucwetha amadoda uMzulwini, nangebuza lapho ethi uMzulwini singasemsamnye ukuthi uzokwazi kanjani ukuthi uJesu and ugcwaliswe ngomoya ongcwele.
It's a good question mfethu. It's a good question futhi uzosiza kakhulu. Khona into engishilo ekuqaleni khathi ngenza i-example of the light and the darkness. You see mfethu, ngoba ngisho ukuthi emhlabeni we are not perfect, but we are being sanctified, right? He sanctifies those. He perfects those he sanctified. Listen, John. He perfects those he sanctified. Because we are not perfect, but we are being sanctified. But can you show John? John chapter. Open the answer, I'm reading. John chapter 1. First John chapter 1, verse 5. First John chapter 1, verse 5. Uthi, if we say we have fellowship with him, but we walk in darkness, we lie and we do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is the light, we have fellowship with him, with one another, and the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sin, he is faithful and just to forgive our sin and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not with us. Ngoba ngisho ukuthi umoya kaNkulunkulu, one of izinto umoya engcwele azele ukuzosenza uzoyenza emhlabeni is to help us. He's our helper, he's our comforter. He's leading us into all righteousness. He's leading us into holiness. He is our positive guarantee of the things yet to come. So what umoya engcwele does to a person, one, he makes sure that you are always with peace with God. You must remain a son of God who is at peace with God, right? How does he do this, umoya engcwele? He made it, uthi Jesu umoya engcwele, when he comes, he's going to testify about him and he's going to glorify Jesus. If you see, one of the things that must happen to you as a child of God, Jesus Christ must be glorified in you. You must be satisfied in Jesus. You must love Jesus. You must love God. Right? That's the work of the Holy Spirit. When you wake up exhaling, you're honoring God. You're honoring Jesus. That's not you, because there is nothing good that comes out of your flesh. It's the Holy Spirit revealing that to you, revealing who Jesus is, and he's making him the master of your life. Right? So that's the work of the Holy Spirit. That is why every day you must fight to see Jesus glorified. Every day when I wake up in the morning, I should see Jesus being glorified. I should elevate him. I should find joy and peace in him. When that happens, Holy Spirit does that. It's not me. It's not my work. That's the work of the Holy Spirit. Number two. Holy Spirit is there to guide you into all truth. What is the truth? Is it truth Christ is always in the Lord? So, which means when you live according to the word of God, when you live or fighting a fight of trying to live according to the standard of God, it is not you. It is the Holy Spirit. Hence, even the part of repentance, comes from the Holy Spirit. When you sin willingly and you not repenting, nothing that is commanding you to repent, you must start to be worried. You are living a life and you've been sinning and you are enjoying that sin. There is nothing you that's compelling to repentance. Start to be worried. Try to pray to God differently, because that's the presence of the Holy Spirit in our soul currently. Because when I'm in darkness, he must lead me to the light, and the light shall never be prevailed by the darkness. I wanna end with this, my brother. Philippians chapter 6, verse 1. Let's go to Philippians chapter 2, verse 12 to 13. Therefore, beloved, as you have obeyed, not in my presence, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who works in you, both will and to do his good pleasures. Chapter 1, verse 6. Lord, be confident of this very thing, that he who has begun the good work will bring it to completion. There is only sin that can come out of my flesh. It is only through the work of the Holy Spirit and the work of God. Why is this in this is an assurance that no one who is in God will fail. That is why we have confidence that no one will lose salvation. Because it is God who has begun the good work. It is God who has bring it to completion. Chapter 2, verse 12, it is God who is willing both the will and for his pleasure. No one will fail. No one will be left out. No one won't reach to God, to his glory, to be with him, as long as he is trusting Jesus, as long as he abides in Jesus, as long as he enjoys and stay in the power of the Holy Spirit. It is not our work, it is the work that God is doing. Because work out your own salvation. For it's God who is working. You're working out your own salvation, for God is at work. Which means it ends with, I'm working out my salvation with fear and trembling. It's because God is working it. So I should allow God to work it and adore God, elevate God, see him as beautiful, see him as the source of life, in fear, knowing that he is God alone. When that happens, God will lead us into glory and no one will be lost, because salvation is for all those who came to believe to his son.
Okay. Why does God instruct men to repent? Then if the Holy Spirit does it on our behalf? Okay. All right, I see.
The Holy Spirit is not doing it on our own behalf. No, it's us who repent. But the what is your repenter? Umoyengwele, who's helping us? Who's born with njengamanje, we are in sin, and he's leading us unto grace. Because umoyengwele uyazi ukuthi sino Jesu in the book of Hebrews chapter 10. Sino sine high priest which is there in the altar of grace in heaven, who understand and sympathize with our weakness. So when you are long, so when you are in sin, Moengwele will give you the spirit of repentance. Not Moengwele you have repentela. No, you as yourself, you should go. But when you do that, and praise God, because the spirit of God is still at work in you. I want to clarify that part.
No, I won't. Bafethu, ngenxa yesikhathi-ke niyazi-ke nani ukuthi isikhathi is always against us. But ngiyathemba ukuthi bafethu namhlanje ndlile Okay, Barnabas, mfundisi ukhulume kahle, but I have an unfinished business with someone. Kazubani ke lo Barnabas. Ay madod, siyabuya la kama comment. No, man of God, thank you very much for sharing the word of God with us namhlanje, for also uklerisha indawo eyiningi mhlambe la ebesingaboni kahle khona. Njengoba ushilo nje ekuqaleni makuthi mhlaba nemizwa ngomfundisi ukuthi but it's true ukuthi iBhayibheli sonke siyalifunda and asoze si understand ngendlela efanayo noma ngendlela eyodwa sonke. So that is why also we are having ama platform akanje and share our different perceptions, but at the end of the day we want to come into a common ground. So indlela eniphendula ngayo, I don't want to lie, angifuni ukasho. Ngiyayithanda indlela eniphendula ngayo ngoba number one akukuxabana, akukhukulwa. It's just you showing ukuthi no, mina ngiyaphikisana nalokhu, ngiku-understanda ngale ndlela. That is why ke bazalwane, next week soba nabantu abawu-2. Next week we are having 2 guests abaphikisanayo, abazobe besho ukuthi njengoba uphika wena ukuthi umuntu ngeke alahlekele insinzo yakho, usholisho ngakini nalo othi lo, nalo othi umuntu engalahlekelwe insindiso yakhe nayo. So next week it's going to be more interesting, but today was very very interesting and sifunde kakhulu. If you feel late, hamba uqala ngasekuqaleni ukuze uzoyilanda kahle, and then ubhale phansi nama scriptures, amavesi ekade ebhala ukuthi uzoyifundela wena. Ifundisene nento bafethu ukuthi even a church made kushunyayelwa, bhala phansi uma sofika endlini suwedwa ustadishe izwi. Ungagcini ngokufunda amavesi, but also study the word of God. It's good to know scriptures, but also the more important part is to understand the word of God. And we understand the word of God through the Holy Spirit. So asibonge kakhulu nani niyazi bafethu, Revelation Time Show, it's where we preach and teach the word of God. It's all about Jesus Christ and him alone, him crucified. Izinto esidiscussa la izinto eziphathelene nombuso kaNkulunkulu, and embusweni kaNkulunkulu inkosi yethu khona uJesu Christ waseNazareth. My brother, akazi noma khona yena usafisa ukusho mfethu uphefumule sesivala mhlawumbe before sivale.
No, fethu ngibonga kakhulu bra, for this session. It's really ekugcineni it's all about edifying the church. Ekugcineni it's all about us trying to reach the end goal. There are, you know, we receive the promise evela kuNkulunkulu ethi sonke siyayikazimulani, sonke siyohlala noBaba ezulwini, sonke we're gonna spend our time in eternity. So let us hold fast that which you have received from the Bible. Let us walk in faith. Let us walk in a manner that is worthy of our calling. Let us enjoy and persevere whatever that is happening in our life as begezele until the last end, because laba obegezele try by igcineni banemqele yabo. I still want to say and emphasize this point. We are Christians, we are brothers. Let us not divide over scriptures. If there is a doctrine and how to understand now, let us all do it in love, let us all do it in peace. Let us not make mistake. We are fighting, but it's all about trying to make sure we have a common goal. It's okay. The love of God may consume our soul, may consume our mind until symbol which is Lord. Amen.
Very much, man of God. So, sesifike emaphethini nohlelo lethu. Asiphinde sihlangane next week, Sunday evening, the All Belong to Revelation Time Show, where we preach and teach the word of God. Unkulunkulu anibusise, siyoqala isonto elisha kusasa kumsombuluko. Nivuke kahle konke abasebenzayo, sithi bavuke kahle bayemsebenzini. Abangasebenzi, we speak the word of God, we speak blessing upon your life. Ukuthi may you receive good news, whether you want to work or you start your own business. May you receive the good news. Thank you very much, Bafethu. I pin the ibunane, same time, same place, Ntambama, and guess what? It was 7 o'clock. Thank you very much. Holoba, asibonge, my brother. May God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Sharp.